On arrival, before removing any existing frames, check that the replacements are correct to the survey regarding size, handling of openers, sill size, etc. When checking sizes, ensure that the new frames will have a 5mm expansion gap around the perimeter. Once satisfied that the frame is correct, begin the removal of the old frame. It's good practice to run a sharp blade around the inside perimeter of the old window to break the bond between the frame and the plaster. This will minimise the damage to decoration and the reveal plaster. Take out as much glazing as possible in order to reduce weight and allow easier handling. Remove old fixings, break the external silicon seal with a blade, and remove external brick corners in order to release the old frame. After removal of the window, clean off all old sealant and debris from the brickwork aperture. If the old mortar bed at the sill is sound, it may be left in place, but first check that there is sufficient clearance. If not, remove it. Prepare the external sill for fitting to the new frame. This may be either fitted full width, with horns that locate into the wall, or alternatively rebated to fit around the brickwork to give a neat finish. Remove any packaging from the new frame and screw the sill onto the bottom of the frame, selecting screws that will not penetrate the inner skin of the frame. Be sure to seal the ends of the sill and frame assembly to prevent moisture from tracking along the sill and into the brickwork. Carefully position the new frame into the aperture, centralise it, and insert packers underneath to level it and to maintain the 5mm expansion gap. Check that the frame is both level and plumb, and drill fixing holes for the frame sides. These should be drilled approximately 150mm from the top and bottom corners, and then at approximately 600mm centres in between. A minimum of 2 fixings per side are required. Using suitable fixings, for example nylon sleeve frame anchors or self-tapping masonry screws, fix the sides of the frame to the wall. It's important to position packers between the frame and brickwork at the fixing points to prevent distortion of the frame and to maintain the 5mm expansion gap. Do not over-tighten the fixings. On wider frames, don't forget to fix the top and bottom of the frame too, as this will prevent deflection in windy conditions. Ensure that any holes drilled through the bottom of the frame are sealed with silicone around the screw heads to prevent water ingress to the reinforcing area within the frame. Again, ensure that packers are positioned adjacent to the fixings to prevent distortion and maintain the 5mm expansion gap. Using a chisel, break off the excess length of the packers to give a neat finish. Before commencing the final stages, clean any brick dust or debris from the frame and surrounding area. Commence glazing the frame, ensuring that appropriate glazing platforms are fitted around each aperture. These will centralise the glass and allow free passage of water into the drainage slots. Place each pane into position, noting that where opening casements are hinged from the sides, they should have the glass packed at diagonally opposing corners to hold the casement square. This process is called towing and healing, and more information is available from Eurocell on request. As each pane is positioned, the beading can be located using a nylon mallet to tap it securely into place. It's recommended the beads be fitted in their original locations and that the horizontal beads are fitted first. Measure and fit any internal trims required, ensuring that the area is clean and dust-free to allow a good bond to the frame. Trims may be fitted using a suitable PVC adhesive or a bead of silicone. Prior to sealing the frame to the internal wall, clean the frame and glass to remove dust or grit. When using cleaning agents, be sure to keep the room well ventilated. Run a strip of masking tape around the perimeter of the frame, then apply a bead of sealant between the frame and the wall. It's advisable to use an acrylic sealant or decorator's caulk internally, as this will allow redecoration. When all four sides have been sealed, and before the sealant sets, the tape can be peeled away carefully, resulting in a neat, clean finish. Ensure that any trims fitted are bonded to the frame to prevent dirt entering the joint. Internal work is now complete. Apply the end caps to the external sill using a suitable adhesive. Clean the external surfaces to remove dust and grit. Then apply a strip of masking tape to the frame perimeter. Apply a smooth bead of silicone sealant between the frame and brickwork. Before the sealant sets, remove the masking tape to leave a neat, clean joint. It's important that you remember to seal below the external sill. Once the working area has been cleaned of all debris, step back and admire your new Eurocell window.